Hi, welcome to the QuickerSim CFD Toolbox for MATLAB tutorial number 4. In this tutorial, we will demonstrate how to use the stabilization algorithms in order to obtain better numerical simulations. We will be solving a very simple problem, that means an advection-diffusion problem in a rectangular domain. Advection-diffusion problems are given by the equation A times gradient of the function is equal to divergence of viscosity times gradient of a function plus some forcing. You can encounter those kinds of problems in, for example, in heat transfer or in transport of chemical species. U is this time the unknown quantity, for example, this temperature or concentration, and A is the advection velocity. The larger the ratio of velocity to viscosity is, the more difficult the problem gets to solve. Okay, so the advection velocity actually gets decomposed into x and y component, where simply it's aligned along x, so it's just 1, and y is zeros. After that, we assemble the diffusion matrix using those functions, and for now, no stabilization is used. The stabilization occurs actually at the moment of assembly. We compute the final resultant matrix. We impose the boundary conditions here by 0 on the left, on the right hand side. Top and bottom by default are set to symmetry, so you do not need to impose them. And we solve the system. Remember that there are no iterative loops needed because the advection diffusion problem is linear. After the system is solved, we simply plot the solution, apply extra labels, and we actually plot 1D solution as well and compare it with the analytical solution that is given by this formula. Okay, let's just run the code. So, yeah, you can see the two-dimensional solution, which is simply like an elongation of 1D, and you can just see how the 1D looks like. That's simply the main line cross section. And here on this plot, the analytical solution is being compared to the numerical solution. Okay, so far we can see that we obtained a pretty nice solution without any extra stabilization. But look what happens when we start manipulating the value of ratio between velocity and viscosity. Let's drop viscosity in 10 times. And you can already see that our solution starts to diverge at the right hand side. You can simply spot those oscillations. And that means that the algorithm hasn't converged at all. That's a typical result for numerical schemes. And what we want to show is the cure for this problem. So you can see that we have this flag, no SUPG. But actually, for now, we will use this SUPG, doubly asymptotic algorithm, for matrix assembly. And we rerun the script. And you can already see that now our numerical solution is stable. Yeah, obviously there is one drawback. It doesn't exactly reproduce the analytical solution. And to some extent, that's the fault of a really coarse mesh used. But anyway, this is the best thing that you can get on such a coarse mesh. The solutions are still stable. So it is highly recommended that you use stabilization. Okay, so that's pretty much for this tutorial. We hope that you enjoyed that. Obviously, please go through other QuickerSim tutorials, get the trial, and subscribe our channel. See you next time.